Hi guys, and welcome back to our channel. In this video, we'll be talking about Web3. That term you probably have heard about in the last few months or even years, and it's taking the whole internet by storm. So we will demystify what's Web3 in the next few minutes. But first of all, this video is only for educational purposes. It's not a financial advice, and let's dive deep into it. So guys, what's Web3? Before we start with Web3, let's go to Web2. Web2 is the current internet we know. It's largely dominated by agencies or big companies, and it's controlling every single bit of information, whether it's your private data, banking details, your social media, your whatever. It's just controlled and censored and heavily regulated by these entities. So Web3 doesn't really depend on anything. Web3 is for the people and by the people. So the issue of Web2 is kind of restriction. It's kind of, you know, it's not really giving enough freedom for everyone to control whatever they want to do on the internet. So Web3 here comes in handy. Decentralization is one of the major advantages of Web3. What's Web3 in the first place? Well, Web3 here, that's a Web3 summit. You can, of course, everything is linked down below. You can understand it more and you can gain more insights about the whole thing. I will be leaving it in the section down below, but here you can look at it and understand the video. Generally speaking here, Web3, simply speaking, can be used as a decentralized tool for you to gain access to what people share, what people use on the internet, or the blockchain to be exact, and people own these bits of information. So the projects on Web3 can be unlimited. It can extend to almost anything. You can just have anything your mind can come across, and it can be applied within the Web3. Web3 will have a revolution in how we use the internet, and it will have given control to people, and it will still give more control to people using the smart contracts. What smart contracts? You probably heard about Ethereum, you probably heard about Polygon and many more. These are smart chains. These are smart contract chains, meaning that you can build upon some parameters and then you can build a project. So here things are quite interesting also with using Web3, because the definition or the defining features of Web3 can be decentralization, data ownership, and that's kind of a different application that can work seamlessly, so it can be interconnected with everything else, and of course governance. One of the major issues right now with Web3 is governance, because it can be quite restrictive or clashing with some regulation, some normal regulation right now, but it's gonna be very soon that everything will be resolved and people will own what's going on in their social medias or their accounts or whatever. So it can be governance that's kind of moving also towards being one of the advantages of Web3. And these features here can be beneficial for the society at large, and also for entities, for people, for everyone using the internet whenever they rely on the blockchain technology and of course Web3. So here the education, you can find here an education tab to understand more about Web3 and understand more about the Web3 courses. Everything also is linked down below in the description. And the core development here, these are the tutorials you can scroll through and understand what's going on. So one of the major links for Web3 is of course cryptocurrency. What's cryptocurrency? Well, cryptocurrencies are using blockchain technology to transfer or to just have a transactional values of coins or of any value actually. So the digital currency is for global transactions. Of course, you know Bitcoin, of course, you know a term called DeFi, decentralized finance. It's not really controlled by a bank or whatever. It's DeFi, decentralized finance. You know the non-fungible tokens, which is NFTs, and also you know the dApps, which is decentralized apps. Everything decentralized is owned by the people and for the people, and this is because of Web3. The concept of Web3 is enabling all of that in help, of course, with the blockchain technology. So you can have a look and have a glimpse of all the cryptocurrencies. Everything is relying on blockchain technology, and that's powering Web3. And of course, Web3 is powering new apps, new applications, new contracts, new innovations, even using Web3 concepts. So getting started with Web3, it's actually easier than you think. It's kind of choosing a cryptocurrency wallet and exploring the blockchain project you want through the dApps, and then the security measure and protection of their assets. So you can have a look at any cryptocurrency you want, anything, Bitcoin, Ethereum, BNB, anything you want. And then once you have an online wallet, it doesn't have to be paid, it can be completely empty, but once you have a wallet, you're on the blockchain control, or kind of holds a ledger or holds record for every single thing you do.
and it's public. So there is no way that things can be quite sketchy there. And the security has come a long way, all the way back since Bitcoin started life until now. Security in the blockchain has come a long way. So I would highly advise you to have a look at everything in the description down below. Understand the term Web3 even more. Everything here also in the description can help you get starting with Web3. And you're already starting to use Web3 since you started to look for the definition of Web3. I assume that you started to have some interest in Web3 and how to maneuver your way around it. So everything in the link below will help you to understand it more, and also check out some new videos, some other videos, and gain more information. But generally, Web3 is the future, and there is no doubt about it. Everything is just using Web3 right now, and delivering Web3 applications is gonna be paramount for excelling any project in the very near future.
So guys, in a nutshell, we talked about Web3. What's Web3? How to differentiate or how to distinguish between Web3 and Web2? And what are the vast advantages for using Web3, and what's coming for the future for Web3? Everything is linked down below in the description. And also, I would highly encourage you to check other videos on the channel. It's very informative, very educational, and you will gain more information. Hit the thumbs up, hit the subscribe button, leave any comment you might have in the comment section down below, and till next time, bye bye.